Parliament commenced sittings after a two-week break. Upon resumption of proceedings, the Speaker directed the testing of all MPs and staff of the Parliamentary Service for COVID-19.
In addition to observing the established protocols, I have directed, on the authority of the Parliamentary Service Board, the Clerk and Parliament's medical officers to liaise with appropriate institutions to immediately conduct testing for all honourable members and staff of the Parliamentary Service for COVID-19. I request your cooperation in this enterprise.
The Health Minister, Kwiku Ajimamenu, was in the House to give an update to members on the case count of COVID-19 and the situation with meningitis in the Upper East and West regions.
So, Speaker, week 20 ended yesterday, the 17th of May 2020, with 42 new cases, bringing the total case count to 315 cases. Mr. Speaker, we have unfortunately recorded two more deaths since the last count 2 weeks ago, bringing the total number of deaths to 45 deaths. No death was recorded in both weeks 19 and 20. The last two numbers or updates for our case counts produced active case counts 4,050 and 3,952 respectively. As at 15th, total case count went up to 5,735, but due to large recovery numbers, the net count of or active cases dropped to 3,152.
Some MPs contributed to the deliberations on the matter.
I want to see on TV some evidence of death admissions, because when you state that this number of people are dead, but they have not seen anything like that. Because I'm giving you a feedback. It's not from me. I'm giving you a feedback. And as leaders and government, what we do here is to give you a feedback. So you don't need to be emotional. You don't need to, like somebody's not believing you and that kind of thing. It's just a feedback I'm giving.
Mr. Speaker, if you have to spend an hour talking about the things you have done, then you have done nothing. Because the very things you have done will speak for you. Unquote. Mr. Speaker, we might be doing well as a country, but I also think that we are talking too much as a government. I'm not really interrogating and explaining the data that we are bringing out. The standard is that your patient must first be well without any symptoms. That's the first stage. Secondly, your patient must test negative. That's the second stage. And then thirdly, your patient must go for a second test and record a second negative successive test before you are tagged with COVID. So if today, 1,000 individuals who are doing well and fine, who have tested negative already and are in their own, either at isolation or in their own homes, all they are waiting for is for Noguchi to bring their sample result and tell us that it's negative for the second time. So tomorrow morning, when you hear that 1,000 more people have recovered, it doesn't mean they were vomiting and now they can eat. It only tells you that their second negative test has arrived.
Parliament is back in session for the second meeting of the year, with a directive from the Speaker for all members and all staff of Parliamentary Service to be tested for the coronavirus disease. Reporting from Parliament, my name is Duke Mensopoku for City News.